Hey all, Remix is another amazing framework for JavaScript. Yes, I know, yet another JavaScript framework, but this is becoming very popular and it's better to try out. Rest will be the experience. So this is the first time I'm also exploring this Remix with you all. So it could be just a tutorial with the exploration. So I'm first time going here, and first I will go on the remix.run, then go here and click on the get started. It says that you need to run this command. So copy this command from here and then go back to terminal and paste it. Now this is going to say that, hey, do you want to install? And if it is asking for create remix installation, just say yes, whatever it is asking. Now it's creating the new remix application, and this is going to use the template. Template means an example application with a blog tutorial. After that, we just need to run the npm run dev, and it will open the localhost 3000. It's all the normal steps for any JavaScript framework. Let's just wait for this to complete. And now you can see it's asking, do you want TypeScript or JavaScript? Obviously the TypeScript thing. And then once again doing something, your database is not synced with your schema. Which database? So migration.sql. okay, so I think it's using the SQL database is there. We can do something with that, and a lot of things are here. You can see it has Prisma seeding, a lot of things are there. Anyways, let's go inside it, whatever we have, block tutorial, and open this with the code. So dot code, oops, code dot whatever it is, it's something is bad happened. Okay, I'm going to close it. Let's open the terminal, code dot, not dot code. Okay, so this is the full ready to use remix application, and I'm going to say npm run dev. This is the one we need to use and we need to run. Localhost 3000 is here, and go localhost 3000. Whoa, amazing, nice home page in the stack. There's some readme login system. If I go to the login, oh, it already have the authentication. Cool. Can we do the sign up? Hey, Sarthak at bitfumes.com, secret 123, create account. Oops, the account is created right here, right now. So view notes for the Bitfumes, Sarthak at Bitfumes, log out. Cool, cool, everything is cool. Create a new note, title is my first note on Remix, and click on save. Okay, that's done. We have this one. We can create another one. We can see the node. We can delete this node. And wow, this is so great. Or it's using a lot of thing SQLite. So there should be an SQLite database somewhere. So SQLite DB, 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 DB. So Prisma is there. Yeah, data.db is here. Cool. That's nice. They are using Cypress for the testing, and they are using a Docker file here to use this remix with the Docker. Amazing. And also, you see this, the Tailwind CSS is there. Tailwind CSS is all-time favorite for each and everyone. It is using white, you know, white. It is from Vue world, so white is there. This is amazing. Let's go in the package.json and see what next we have. We have Prisma, Prisma, everything is there. Bcrypt for obviously creating the hashed password, that is Bcrypt. It's using the React, React DOM. Okay, so a lot of amazing things is here inside this remix. Okay, so let's go once again here, and it says that create your first route. How we can create? So you need to go to the app routes index.tsx. So app, then routes, then index.tsx is here, and then Here inside this, we can see it's all React, and this is link tag, just like we have on the Next.js. So it says that anywhere you can put this command, or not this command, this code. So copy this, and we can just paste it here. After this, yeah, cool. So we are done with this, and let's go and see. Do we have, yeah, we have this blog post. You can see this blog post is there. So click, it says not found. Wow, we have a not found page. So somewhere we should have a not found page. Maybe it could be the one which is coming from the remix itself. Okay, we will see that later. But next, it says that, hey, you will find this blog post, and then create a new file called post and then index.tsx. So inside the route, let's create post slash index.tsx, and then it says what we need to do. We need to create a simple create this simple functional component just like this, and I think this is done. So loading the data, we will talk about that loading data after that, but let's reload. No, it's not done. So posts index is there. Oh, so it should be posts, not just post. And reload. Yeah, so you can see we have this post. Great. And this means we can now fetch the data from our database. And we have this hook, the React hook, for loading the data. And then we can run everything. So let's copy that and paste it something like this, and let's see what is it is doing. So use loader data, and use loader data, and we can get the post from that user loader data. And what this is doing, this is a loader thing. We are not using this loader anyways. Let's see what we are getting on the console. So on the console, we are getting array of two things, and this is exactly this one. So I think this is a normal representation of if we are getting the data from the database, then how we can use it. So use loading data, loader data once again. But my point is, this is like a function which is telling to the remix that, hey, this is the database data. So it should be hard coded. It could come from MySQL, Postgres, MongoDB, anywhere. But right now we are doing this, and whatever we export from here is coming inside this use loader data, and we can get it. So we can change it. My first blog post on Bitfumes crash course. If we rerun it, you can see server is restarted. And we have this one on Bitfumes crash course. Cool. So this is really nice to understand and very easy to understand actually. And this time we said that, okay, let's loop over everything and then do it. So we can copy it. No, it's not available to copy. Okay, so what we can do, we can grab the green part and then paste it after it. And it says that you need to import it from remix. So remix react, remix run react link is imported. And now it says, okay, so we are using the TypeScript. So for now I'm using any just to suppress the error, which is not a good thing for TypeScript. But let's reload it. And yay, we have these two blog posts here available from our database, which is not a real database. It's actually our hard-coded thing. So this is the one. Cool. Now let's see what next we have to do. So it says that, hey, TypeScript is really mad thing. So they are giving the type, and we can get that type and put that type here or anywhere you want. Next, it says that you can define the data we are sending. So we are sending an array of posts. So we can say that, hey, the JSON we are having here is a type of loader data, and then it should be giving here. It says that use loader data is having a type of loader data. So loader data, and then it should provide the post. And yeah, so post should also be there. We can provide it, but it's okay because TypeScript know that if we are getting the post, it should be the type of the post, because loader data is an array of post and loader data include post and everything is there. Cool. So this is the TypeScript issue we have done. Now it says that little refactoring thing. So I told you I'm doing this first time with you all. So it's really interesting for me also. So what we have to do, we have to say that create a new file called post.server.ts. Okay, whatever it is saying, let's do that. But where we have to create it? In the models. Cool. So in the model, let's create post.server.ts. Yes. And let's put all these code inside it and let's understand it. Okay, so whatever we were doing inside this route file, we have this loader data, we have this TypeScript types, we are using that here. Okay, and when we run the get post function, it is going to return a promise, and which is actually going to give you the real data you want. Okay, so this means it says that, hey, you are making a get post function. It's a asynchronous function which is mimicking the data coming from the database. Okay, now in our route post, we will going to use this model to fetch the data. Okay, so let's go here once again, and we don't need these two things. We don't need this loader. But then question comes, how we can get the data? So it says that you need to export, or you need to import this function, get post function, and then we can say that, hey, type loader data is await of return type and the type of get post. If you are not aware of this thing, you will find the TypeScript course in my Bitfumes YouTube channel. You will find it and you will going to understand how and what these are things. But for now, we can see that we can just copy all these things, paste it here, and that's done. Everything is absolutely same. So this means once again, the posts are here. So the difference is, now we are using this get post function, which is returning a promise, an asynchronous function, and then whatever it's returning, we are waiting for it. We are doing the JSON, and it's exactly same which we were doing right here. But the difference is this data is coming from the model. Okay, and then we have created a loader data, which we were using it previously also. This time it's just an await thing, and it says that this is handy way to say post is whatever type get post resolved to. So this means the type of get post will come here. Okay, once again, if you're not getting, check out the TypeScript course. Cool, this is great, and everything is still working nice. Now, pulling data from the data source. We know we need to use the SQLite data, and SQLite data is inside this Prisma. So Prisma data.db is there. We should create some kind of migration, some kind of data structure. So you can see it says that, hey, first you need to update the Prisma schema and create another model for the post. So let's copy this, and we need to go inside this Prisma folder. Here we are. Schema.prisma is there. A lot of other schemas are there, but at the bottom, I'm going to add one more. And this means now it should create this model. Okay, so let's say what it says that. Now let's tell Prisma to update the local database and TypeScript definition to match this schema changes. So let's run this command, which is going to actually create the database structure in our database. and everything is done. Cool. And once we are done with this, we can use the seeding. And what is seeding? Seeding means adding a fake data into the database. So it says that on the seed.ts, you have to run this thing. So like here. So let's go. Do we have something in the seed.ts? Yes, we have something in the seed.ts, but how we can add it? Const post. Okay. Do we have something like const? Okay, yeah, this one is there. Prism. This is a const for prism only. Maybe I can add it here and see. Nope. Something is wrong. It's inside seed.ts. Okay, what it says that let's seed our database with a couple of posts. Open seed.ts and add to the end of the seed functionality right before console log. So where is the console log? Console.log is there right before the console log. This means this is the console log, and right before I'm going to add it. Okay, so this is good. Now it says post is rejected, this TypeScript problem. Okay, so note that we are using upsert, so you can run the seed script over and over without adding multiple version of the same post. So what we are doing, we have this post array where we have a slug title markdown thing, and then again slug title markdown data, markdown data, and then we are looping through all the post, and then we say prisma post dot upsert. Upsert means if not available then create. Okay, it's not going to override. So where slug is whatever the slug we are passing, update the post or create the post. Okay, so this is how we are doing all these things. Okay, what next? Once again, we need to say npm npx prisma db seed. Okay, so run this one, prisma db seed, and it says running the seed. Seeding is done. This means we should have something in our database. How we can check? It says now update the post.server.ts to read the file from SQLi database. This is really important. See what we were doing. Let's go to the post.server.ts, which is inside app model post.server.ts. Before we were doing this thing. This is just a hard-coded thing, but we want now to get the data from the database. So once again, let's go to the server thing, and here we need to see, we can use the Prisma to get all the post. So this is just only thing we need to do. So returning this, and we don't need to provide any return schema, and we just need to import the Prisma. So Prisma client is there. Is this a Prisma client? Import Prisma from server DB. Okay, so it's import DB server. This one, we don't need the type. Everything is done, but it's still saying some problem with the post. That's a TypeScript issue. No worries for that, but we need to worry. You cannot read the property post. I think I did something wrong. Something is wrong here. Maybe we should restart the server. I don't know. This should not be the case, but let's try this out. Yeah, okay, so you can see it is back with these two things, my first post and my made whatever it is. so the point was to restart the server. Okay, so everything is working fine now, and then we can see we have this dynamic route parameter, so we can create the dynamic routing here also. So to create the dynamic route, we can have these two things. So what we are basically doing, we have these two, and whenever we click, we don't have any page for it. So we need to create these kind of pages. So we can say that we have to create $slug.tsx inside the post route. So we have app, then we have a route, we have a post. Then here we can create like $slug.tsx. Once we have that, we can copy this and paste it. That's really nice, and this should be available. And yes, you can see some post is there. That means whatever we are doing, we have the page. We have the page for posts slash whatever we provide. So if we provide anything, yes, we are returning the same page. But we need to return the data for the particular blog. Okay, so it says that, hey, on the slug, you can use the use loader data once again and get the slug from here. So use loader data. So use loader data should come from here. And now we can just use this export loader, because if we want to use the use loader data, we need to export this function, which is as a sync function. And here we should get the parameters. So from the parameter, we get the slug. And here we can just show the slug, some post and the slug, since it's basically a React thing. So we can directly use the curly braces. Now we have this JSON thing. So we need to use the JSON from remix node. So copy and done this. And after that, it says that, hey, if you're having issue with the TypeScript, then you need to use loader function as the, you can say the type. So let's just define this loader function as the type here and import this from remix. And it's not imported. Why? So maybe I can manually copy and paste this one. Okay, so you can see now error is gone for the TypeScript. Let's now move to the browser, and here let's go to anyone. And now you can see whatever we define on our URL as the parameter or the slug, that comes here. So if we say Sarthak, and comes here because we have done something like that. So let's move to the next thing, is something for our post, the get post. Add the get post function to our module, to our model. Here we are, the post.server.ts. Previously we had created the get posts, like finding all the posts. This time we only want the single post. So copy this one and then open the model inside post.server.ts and paste it. Everything is fine. And now let's see how we can use it. So we need to use this function get post from our model, and then instead of just returning the slug, which we are doing here, we are just returning the slug, we want to return the post. For that, we just need to run this function by providing the slug. So what actually we are doing, when we have this, when we run this get post, it will need the slug as a string, and it will find a unique, find unique where the slug is, the slug which we have provided inside the database. Okay, so this means we need to say const post is equal to await of get post, and get post from our server, the post model, post.server, and then parents.slug. Okay, this is done, and here we are doing the same thing and returning the JSON for the post only. So here we are with the post. Okay, so everything is good. And now instead of slug, we can get the post. So get the post, and we say, hey, post dot title. Okay, this is done. Let's restart the server, because previously we had the issue. So let's go, and now it says reading of undefined, something is wrong here. So params dot slug is good, and it says that something is not good here. So why not we can just copy and see if we are doing something wrong. No, we are not doing anything wrong. Everything is fine. So yes, because there is no post with the Sarthak, that's why it was having issue. So suppose we go to the slash posts, this URL, we get these two posts in our system, in our database, and when we click on one, we get the title. That's great. Now it says, let's make TypeScript happy. This means we need to create a loader data. So something like this. Yeah, and then we need the type for the post, and we can get from here from the server. So like here, but then it says that, hey, you don't have this type, and we also need the invariant. So copy and paste it, invariant. But where we use this invariant? We will use this invariant so that we will not get any error if the post is not available. So after this, when we fetch the post, we will use invariant, which is just going to say post not found. Okay, and then we define the data type for the JSON we are returning. So it's loader data, and similar to that we need here. Okay, the only thing remain is the post type is not returning from the server. Is this the real issue? I missed something. Okay, so I didn't have any post type. Okay, so I think I need to add this one. I missed this. So go to post.server and return this one, and now everything is good. So let's restart the server, go reload, everything is fine. But what if I provide a slug which is not available, something like this? Now you can see it's a good and nice error, which is saying that post not found for the slug of Sarthak. Great, let's move forward. And next is we have made TypeScript happy. Everything is fine. Then it says that we need to use a library called marked, so that, remember, in our cedar, in our Prisma cedar, we have used this markdown thing for our post. Okay, so let's install this marked in our Prism, in our remix project. After that, if we are using the TypeScript, which we are doing, we need to add the types for the marked also. And then inside the file where we have created the dynamic routing, and the dynamic routing is inside the slug for the post, like this. And you can see we are having this slug, but we also have some details. So if I say post body, okay, and this should be how we can understand Prisma schema. Schema is markdown, I think. Is it markdown? Yeah, markdown thing. Okay, so instead of title, I say post markdown. If I go and check reload, you can see we have literally exact markdown available, but we don't want that. We want the real markdown parsed thing in a HTML form. So that's why we need to first change the type, and we need to say that, hey, it also need a HTML string thing. So this is the loader data need the post, but also need HTML thing as a string. Okay. Now what it says that once you get the post, then you need to convert the post markdown thing and call it a HTML, and then return that HTML also. So once we get the post, then we say that, hey, post.markdown will be parsed with the markdown thing. Let's import the markdown, which is here. And then just after this, we also return the HTML. So since we are returning on this loader, we are loading all the data, then we can accept the HTML here, and instead of post.markdown, we can say, hey, I need the HTML. Let's see. Okay, so this is having issue that it has literally printed the HTML. So how we can convert this? We just need to use this dangerously set inner. It's a React thing. If you don't know, you can check out the 10 hour of React course on Bitfumes YouTube channel. Then I can just paste it and it's going to work absolutely fine. And now you can see everything is really great. This is the title. This is the you can say the details with this, which was written in Markdown and now available like this. Okay, so I think we have used inside H1. So let's remove from H1. It will look better like here. Okay, that's great. You can learn more about this remix with the nested routing and a lot more thing, and obviously full documentation is there, and I told you that it's really really easy and fun working with the remix. Everything is available on remix. You don't have to go anywhere else. So this is the crash course for remix, introduction to remix. I hope you liked it. If you like it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to Bitfumes YouTube channel. If you have not subscribed yet, follow Bitfumes on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, anywhere you want, and tell me which crash course you really want to have on the Bitfumes YouTube channel from my side. I will surely going to create on that, and that's my promise. So see you on another big course.